Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the line at Basford. It is Wednesday night. It is our general knowledge quiz. Apologies, I'm getting feedback on my other speakers. It's the Wednesday night virtual general knowledge quiz during lockdown. Good evening. My name's Shaun. I am the Quiz Man. You find me and the pub on Facebook. Most of you already here already if you've not joined with friends. Tonight's quiz is 6 rounds in total. Round 1 is your pitch round. If you've not already done so, your pitches are available on the event page. I paste the link into the chat. In there you should be able to find the pitches. The 10 pitches, 1 to 9, name the people. Number 10, name the object. Here we go. I'm going to paste them on here as well, so there's a slideshow of them going through. 1 to 9 people, number 10, name the object. All you need is a piece of paper to write your answers down on, nothing fancy. Any audio problems tonight, let me know. I've got a new mixer on the desk, so I've done a small test, but this is a big test, actually. We also have a strange round coming up halfway through the quiz. I need to do a test with you guys to see if it works before we actually proceed with it. It's worked in testing, but it's only been one or two people. But you will need to see the screen because it is going to hopefully involve some moving pictures. If not, we have a couple of backup rounds anyway. So I'll give you a couple of minutes for people to join in. 1 to 9 on your pictures, name the people. Number 10, name the object. While you guys doing that, I'm going to sort my beer out. What are we drinking tonight? Ba, da, ba, ba. So, you know it's going to be a nice beer when it says suggested food pairings, grilled steak and leeks, rosemary potatoes au gratin, Roquefort blue cheese and creme brulee. It's from Great Divide Brewing Company in the States. And it is Yeti. It's a Imperial Stout. Coming in at 9.5%. There you go. Yeti. So I've had it for about 4 years, I think. So hopefully this one won't go everywhere like the last one did. It's not gone everywhere so far. It's like black treacle. There you go. Just need to make sure I don't get the sediment because it killed me last time I had the sediment out of one of these. There you go. Cheers, everybody. Ooh. Ooh. Mr. Glover, you'd love this. Oh, very nice. So pitch round 1 to 9, name the people. Number 10, name the object. Good evening from the Von Trapp Singers. Who else we got? Engine oil, Gary? No. Tastes far nicer than engine oil, this. It's amazing. I think it's the second bottle I've ever had of this, but... Dickhead Daniel is drinking Heineken. There you go. Even Craig. Even Andrew. Hello from L&J. Playing from Spain for the first time. Yeah, just stay on there, Carly. We will read the questions out. You just need a piece of paper to answer your questions. Some of them are on screen at the moment. Some may be on screen later, depending on how the technology works. And it's all for fun, so you just tell us your score at the end. Be as honest as you can with yourself. We've got the Wardles are here. Dobbies are here. Helen and Rich. Lord and Ladyship of the Glover. The Quizman and her are here in Nottingham. How dare you? That's my name. I've even got a Facebook page for it. James is here, Jax is here. Who else we got? 4 households, 2 countries. What countries are you in this time, Kev? Come on. The monkey's here as well. Good evening, Peter. I keep seeing posters for you, tea bags and brewing companies. I don't know if you copyrighted your image. Leicester Forest East. Oh, Dana, that's a bit... Not sure if we can have foreigners in from Leicestershire. You can't see the pictures in the discussion section, Gerb. There's a link and it sends you to the event page. And in there, the pictures are in there, but they're also on the screen at the moment. Matthew, the girls and it are back. Breakfast Club. Just me. Monkeys out of fire. Is it five wise monkeys? Three wise monkeys? What we got for today? Uber Troopers are here. NG5 Ravers. On the Dancing Beer. Team Not So Smart. Quiz in my hair. Grudgeon's family. I like this. Getting up to the 160s again. Always like that. All right, I'll let you off then, Jason, if it's just the name. Griffles. Oh, I've not said hello to you from Matlock. No, I haven't. Sandra, you're only around the corner from me. Down there, 6:10. So I'll be nice with you. Hello from Derek and Sandra in Matlock. There you go. Special hello for you, Sandra. Are the chippies open in Matlock still? Quick Jizz. Knob's here. The Healy's are here. Barn Owls, Dukes of Hazzard in the house, fifth week running. I like that consistency there, Jane. A-Up Bab, East and West Midlands. Oh God, Mr. Duffy's here. Hopefully you've got the brain that is Cameron with you. He's just quite excited because I've said his name. What's on the t-shirt? It says take the sh out of it. There you go. No, it's just orange juice. It's been there all day while I've been working. No chippies open or scandalous. Ours are open. It's click and collect only. It's gone like B&Q. Quiz you bank in the house. Richard on the ghost ship. There you go. Today at work at lunchtime for a bit of old Pebble Boys are here as well, and the Von Tramp family swingers. Guten Tag. Yeah, so on lunchtime today we did baby photos trying to guess who was who. I decided to submit two of myself. One of them is about 6 to 8 years before The Simpsons started, and I have Bart Simpson's hair before Bart Simpson, and it was white blonde as well. So I think I need to claim some copyright infringement from The Simpsons. Right, shall we begin? Before we begin, I'm just going to take away the image slideshow for a second because I want to test something. I want to do some GIFs for the top five round. I want to do scenes from movies, and I want you to tell me the movies. At this point, Ian has just got really, really happy. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a test image and can you just let me know in the chat if it plays and that you can view it. So here you go. That's the image for the test image, and there'll be a case of what film is it from. I now have to wait because you guys want a bit of the delay from me. So does that play okay for you guys watching in Quizland? Mr. Glover says yep. Kev says yep. There you go. All right, okay. Looks like quarantine turnout. Looks like top five, we're going to have a movie round then. All right, we're back to my ugly mug, unfortunately. So, round two is called Read All About It, or In the News, 10 Things That Are Happening in the news for the last 10 days or so. I say, we'll try and reduce the amount of death we talk about on these weeks as they go. The sport is very sparse, as you can imagine. So question one, things that have happened in the last week. Which Scottish singer-songwriter has hit the top of the album charts with the album Bonnie? So which Scottish singer-songwriter has hit the top of the album charts with the album The Bonnie? That's B-O-N-N-Y, The Bonnie. Question two. Which businessman recently requested loans from the UK government to help save his companies, offering his Caribbean island as collateral? So which businessman recently requested loans from the UK government to help save his companies, offering his Caribbean island as collateral? Question three. Question three. Discount retailer Poundland has recorded a surge in sales for its what type of kit, costing £1 for three? So, discount retailer Poundland has recorded a surge in sales for its what type of kit, which costs £1 for a pack of three. Don't worry, Samantha, if you miss any of the questions, we will paste them into the chat at the end of each round so you get to see the questions in front of you. Apologies. The Yeti is already repeating. Question four. Originally set to take place in April and May, which world championship has been rescheduled to start on the 31st of July in Sheffield? I think the big clue is Sheffield. So, originally set to place in April and May, which world championship has been rescheduled to start on the 31st of July in Sheffield? Fingers crossed. Not ignoring you. Question five. It's now a common term in daily language, but what name is given to the what name is given to temporary leave of employees due to special needs of a company or employer, which may be due to economic conditions at the specific employer or in the economy as a whole? So now a common term, what name is given to to temporary leave of employees due to special needs of a company or employer, which may be due to economic conditions at the specific employer or in the economy as a whole? The beer is amazing. Very nice. Some could say too nice. I'm glad I've only got one in my garage store of super strong beers. My other laptop's just decided to tell me a problem. Right. Question 6. Michael O'Neill has permanently left his role after 8 years in charge of which football team? So Michael O'Neill has permanently left his role after eight years in charge of which football team? Think of his name. Think of his name. Terry, I'm drinking Yeti by the Great Divide Brewing Company from over the other side of the pond. It's a 9.5% Imperial Stout. Recommended serve with grilled steak and a creme brulee. It weighs in at a hefty 75 IBUs. From Colorado. No, you didn't buy it, me mum. I buy my own beer. I had it imported from America, actually. And the EPA from Nottingham Brewery. A few of the breweries are being quite good. Lightning are doing little kegs as well for £25, I think. £25-30 for a decent-sized keg. Shipston's are delivering as well. From 1953. Question 7. A combination of Comic Relief and Children in Need. What was the BBC's big charity event entitled last week? So it was a combination of Comic Relief and Children in Need. But what jazzy name did the BBC give their big charity event last week? Was that meant to be Lenton Lane, Julian? You've had a few beers from Lenton Lane tonight, haven't you? Third time lucky? Kenton Kane, Kenton Lane, Lenton Lane finally? Are we going to get there? Yeah, there's a brewery about 200 yards down my mum's road. It's the allotments at Clifton on Sunwood Lane, and they do their own cider. The line actually stock it during the summer months. Julian, is the 200 not out how many you've had tonight, or is that the beer you're having? Zoe, you're not meant to put any answers in the thread, so I'm going to have to hide that. Come on. Hide the comment. There you go. Please don't put answers in the thread, in the comments. It's down to on your households and such like to play. Yeah, Brew Cavern are doing loads of deliveries. Hoptimism in Loughborough are delivering as well. Most of the brewers in Nottingham are doing stuff. So it's all well and good. Emperor's Brewery, which is local to me, or local to Nottingham, and does specialist brews, that just did a recent collaboration, which was released about 8 days ago. And they've been delivering the last couple of days as well via Hoptimism. Question 8. The annual signing of new talent into the American football NFL took place in the last week, albeit by video call for the first time ever. What is the name of this event known as? So the annual signing of new talent into the American football's NFL took place in the last week, albeit by a video call for the first time ever. What was the name of the event is known by? At one point they had 16 cheerleaders on the screen all in separate video calls and they're all doing the same thing. One of the cheerleaders' boyfriends got his phone and walked into the bedroom and she sat in the corner of the bedroom on her knees in front of her iPad doing the cheer. Yay! And she, in her jeans, just with a cheer top on and a pom-poms. It was quite funny. She just looked at him and said, "Why are you videoing me? I'm on live on TV." I like turtles as well, Liam. They're quite nice creatures. I saw your cases of beer, Richard, from Thornbridge. I expect them to be gone by Sunday. Question number 9. The founder of the first pirate radio station in the UK, or off the UK, Ronan O'Reilly, has died aged 79. What was the name of the station? So the founder of the first pirate radio station off the UK, Ronan O'Reilly, has died aged 79. But what was the name of that station? It's O'Reilly, spelled O apostrophe R-A-H-I-L-L-Y. O'Reilly. Yeah, O'Reilly. Yeah. Say it how you see it from what I can tell on this one. No effing clue. Oh, so uncivilized there, Richard. And question 10, the final one in this round. Captain Tom Moore, second week running, has joined forces with Michael Ball and the NHS Voices of Care Choir to cover which classic song? So, Captain Tom Moore has joined forces with Michael Ball, he's a lovely guy, and the NHS Voices of Care Choir on a cover of which classic song? Not slurring yet, Jax. It's just a long day. Right, that's your current affairs round done. The news is complete. After the news, we move on to top five. In your top five round, I'm going to ask you two questions. Each question has five possible answers. That last one was number 10, Jane. So in your top five round, you've got two questions. Each question has five possible answers. One of them is going to be picture-based or movie-based, and one is going to be a question. So, your movies. Let's go try something new for this one. So, I'm going to give you five GIFs, and I want you to tell me the movie the GIF comes from. I'll play them through two or three times. I'll do each one once or twice, and then move on to the next one. So, number one is this one. What's the title of the movie? Jane, the questions are going to be in the chat thread in a second. I'm just pasting them in now. So your first 10 questions are coming in now. There you go. Your first 10 questions, around two questions, are in the chat thread in case you missed anything. So we're going to paste, we're going to put five gifts up from five famous movies. They all start with the same letter to give you a bit of a running chance. And I want you to tell me the title of the film they come from. Here's number one. Number two. Number three. And so I'm going to repeat them two or three times. Number four. And number five. This is round three, Jason. It's top five round. It's the first question. Name the five movies that all begin with the same letter. So that was your first time through. Here they come again. Number one. Number two. I feel like an optician. Is it better with number three? Or is it clearer with number four? Or is it number five? So there you go. Five movies, five small clips, played through twice. Do you need them a third and final time? I'll be nice. One last time through. Number one. Number two. Number three. Number four. And finally, number five. Do I need to do mine? Not quite as good as that one, is it? But yeah, it's getting there. Right, so number five. So five movies, five small clips. Name the movies. They all begin with the same letter. Your second question of round two. I'm going to give you five locations from animated TV, and I want you to tell me the title of the show the animated TV locations come from. So I'll read you the names of the cities out, or the places. I want you to tell me the TV show that they come from. So the five are as follows. You've got Springfield, Bedrock, Greendale, Quahog, and Pontypandy. So five animated TV series locations. What's the TV series they come from? So you've got Springfield, Bedrock, Greendale, Quahog. For those who are not sure, that's spelled Quahog, Quahog, and finally Pontypandy. What's the names of the TV shows those locations are from? Obviously, I'm not going to be able to paste the GIFs into the chat thread, but I will paste question two in there for you. I don't think I'd ever use that same product again, Rich. Once bitten, twice shy, and all that. Right, after round three and your top five, we move on to round four. Round four is your A to Z or your Alpha Links round. In this round, I'm going to ask you 10 questions. If the answer to question one begins with the letter A, the answer to question two begins with letter B, the question three letter C, and so on. Should we get to the letter Z at any point, the next answer begins with the letter A. I always want to give examples, but then I go, are we going to get close to that letter this week? Because I can never remember what I've wrote. Right, so question one. Which home carbonation system was founded in 1991 and was floated on the Nasdaq? Thought I'd made a spelling mistake. So, and it floated on the Nasdaq in 2010. So, which home carbonation system was founded in 1903, not 1991, sorry, in 1903 and floated on the Nasdaq in 2010. So, which home carbonation system was founded in 1903 and floated on the Nasdaq in 2010? Question two, what name is given to the Haribo range of super sour tangy gums? So, what name is given to the Haribo range of super sour tangy gums? Number three, what name links a mythical creature and Britain's biggest supplier of darts equipment? So, what name links a mythical creature and Britain's biggest supplier of darts equipment? Know when you see quite a message late to the pub asking how to join the quiz, I feel awful. Question four: Nicolas Maduro is the current. Oh, I'm saying current. I wrote this and I was going to check it. Is the current president of which South American country? We have James jumping all over me if this is wrong. It's correct. Nicolas Maduro is the current president of which South American country? Soon you say president and South American, it could change like that. I do like the fact we get a regular 170, 180 people on these. It's quite impressive. Thank you. Question at number five. What was the favorite cheese of the animated characters Wallace and Gromit? So what was the favourite cheese of animated characters Wallace and Gromit? Number six. What name was shared by two kings of Persia between 424 BC and 486 BC? So obviously counting backwards there, not forward. So what name is shared by two kings of Persia between 486 BC and 424 BC? Question 7. What is shouted in a popular game if all your five dice are the same number? So, what is shouted in a popular game if all your five dice are the same number? Not a problem, Zoe. We're here to keep you entertained of an evening. Question number 8. In which film did Michael Caine play Lieutenant or Lieutenant Gonville Bromhead? So in which film did Michael Caine play Lieutenant Gonville Bromhead? Question 9. What is the alternative name of the ancient device, also known as a counting frame? So, what is the alternative name of the ancient device, also known as a counting frame? It's not that ancient. I had them at school. Question 10. What name is given to the thin pancakes usually served with caviar? Hang on, Phil, you're older than me, so I must be old. What name is given to the thin pancakes usually served with caviar? They are your 10 questions for round 4. I'll paste them in the chat in a second. After round 4, we move on to round 5. Round 5 is your connections round. In this round, I'm going to give you 4 questions, then a 5th and final, what connects the previous 4 answers. So 4 questions, then a 5th and final, what connects the previous 4 answers for an extra point. Question 1. The triple point of what substance is used to define the Celsius temperature scale? It sounds complicated, it's not. So the triple point of what substance is used to define the Celsius temperature scale? So as we're playing at home and it's not super competitive in the pub, that's the triple point is the point where an element goes between gas, liquid and solid. So the 3 points where it changes its consistency between gas, solid and liquid. Renata, the news round questions are in the chat thread, so if you scroll further up, round 2 questions are currently there. Question 9 is just below your comment. Oh, no, it's... Yeah, so that each round the questions get pasted in. Question 2. Which box office hit of 1990 almost starred Paul Hogan, i.e. Crocodile Dundee, until Patrick Swayze took the lead after Hogan turned it down? So which box office smash hit of 1990 almost starred Paul Hogan until Patrick Swayze took over the lead role after Hogan turned it down at the last minute? I think it'd have been a totally different film if Paul Hogan had done it instead of Patrick Swayze. It'd have been hilarious. Question 3. Wimbledon is now the only Grand Slam tennis tournament played on what surface? So Wimbledon is the only Grand Slam tennis tournament played on what surface? And question four, what mythical creature appears on the flag of Wales? So what mythical creature appears on the flag of Wales? You mean that bit? Apologies, I put my sheet over it by accident. So which mythical creature appears on the flag of Wales? And question five, what links the previous four answers? I might get one of the camera protectors about my work laptop just to hide me when I don't want to look at you to look at me. So what connects the previous four answers? I will paste those four questions into the chat thread. Question two in that round has just appeared in the chat thread for you. After round five, we move on to round six. Round six is your wipeout round. In this round, I'm going to ask you 10 questions. If you get all 10 questions right, you get a bonus of 5 points. If you get anything wrong in this round, you lose all the points for the round. The quiz is often won or lost in this round. It could be a chance to shine yourself in glory or make yourself look a bit foolish. Question 1. The sweets now known as Starburst were known in Britain by what name between 1959 and 1990? So the sweets now known as Starburst were known by what name between 1959 and 1990? Questions for round two are in the chat thread, Rebecca. If we scroll up, they're right towards the top. Each round, the questions are pasted in. Question two. Who played the part of Ron Weasley in the Harry Potter films? So who played the part of Ron Weasley in the Harry Potter films? Forgot to record the quiz again. Question three. Which current major house of fashion manufactured uniform? I think we had this the other week. Which current major house of fashion manufactured uniforms for the German SS during the 1930s? So, which current major house of fashion manufactured uniforms for the German SS during the 1930s? It's always nice to give you a free one. Pippa doll, you know you're being brave when you put things like that in the chat thread. Question four. In the US, they are called thrift shops, and in Australia, they're called op shops. By what name are they known in the UK? So, in the US, they are thrift shops, and in Australia, they are op shops. By what name are they known in the UK? Question 5. Which television presenter is nicknamed the Hamster? So which TV presenter is nicknamed the Hamster? Question 6. The Achilles being an example, what name is given to the strong fibrous tissue that attaches a muscle to a bone? So the Achilles being an example, what is the name given to the strong fibrous tissue that attaches itself or attaches muscle to a bone? Question 7. The Bass Strait separates which island from Australia? So the Bass Strait separates which island from Australia? Australia. Question number 8. Question 8. Who is the lexicographer? It's not you, Duffy, calm down. Who is the lexicographer, adjudicator, and longest serving member of the on-screen team on Countdown? So who is the lexicographer, adjudicator, and longest serving member of the on-screen team on Countdown? Two questions to go. Question number 9. Chris Lowe and Neil Tennant make up which musical duo? So Chris Lowe and Neil Tennant make up which musical duo? I like the teddy bear, Karis. Are you seriously sat cuddling that? And I don't mean Joe either. Question 10. What was the name of the womanizing barman played by Ted Danson in the TV sitcom Cheers? First and surname. If you're going to go for it, let's have the whole thing. So what was the name of the womanizing barman played by Ted Danson in the TV sitcom Cheers? So what was the name of the womanizing barman played by Ted Danson in the TV sitcom Cheers? And as we always say, some of you are playing competitively against each other. Some of you are playing in multiple teams, in different houses, on Zoom and on watch parties. So the tie break for you to make your separation between the teams is, in what year was actress Betty Davis born? So in what year was actress Betty Davis born? She's the one that's got Betty Davis eyes. You'd be surprised at that, wouldn't you? So round six questions are in the chat thread. Take a small comfort break while I run to the gentleman's room. Time for a small bit of advertising, I reckon. For those of you who don't already, my YouTube channel is a fun watch while you're finding things to do at night time when the TV's a bit pointless at the moment. Feel free, Shaun in the Shed, go and subscribe. I just put a nice new coat rack up last week. It's all for making stuff. I've actually started publishing these quizzes on YouTube as well under the thequizmannotts. So if you ever want to sit down with any friends and do a quiz and go, I know all the answers to this one. They're all on there, so you can rerun them again and again should you really get bored. Right, I shall be back in seconds few. I'm just going to remove my camera. But you can have the bar noises back. There you go. Back in about 30 seconds. Apologies, there was a queue. Right. Happy birthday. Yeah, I did, Rich. I sang multiple songs and happy birthday wasn't one of them. And I also had to step over the dog because he was laying in front of the little room. Right, let's go through your answers then. Pictures to begin with, wasn't it? Pictures. There you go. Right, your answers for your pictures. Number one, she looks good with a spoon and without a spoon. It's the lovely Reese Witherspoon. Legally Blonde, Cruel Intentions, Sweet Home Alabama. Number two, Marvin Humes from JLS. I thought I'd go for a tasteful shot of him for anyone that wants to see it. Number three is John Lennon. Number four is Phil the Power Taylor. Darts legend. Number five is William Roach, Mr. Barlow from Coronation Street. Number six, happy birthday today. She's 50 today, is Uma Thurman from Kill Bill and Pulp Fiction. Number seven is Miley Cyrus. Number eight is DJ Sarah Cox from BBC Radio 2. Number nine, you're up close, is Tess Daly, Mrs. Vernon Kay, or the forerunner of the presentation team of Strictly Come Dancing, or Strictly Dancing. Number 10 is a record player or record. We are lenient. It's the home quiz. It's not the pub. We're not fighting over cash. It's a record or record player, whichever you went for. Round two. This was your newers. Things that happened in news for the last 10 days or so. Right. Let's split the answers and everything that side and that side. Right. Which Scottish singer-songwriter has hit the top of the album charts with the album The Bonnie? That's Gerry Cinnamon. Gerry Cinnamon. Number three, Joe, was John Lennon. Hi from Canada, Levi. Welcome. Number two, businessman recently requested loans from the UK government to help with his companies, offering his Caribbean island as collateral, was Richard Branson. Number three, discount retailer Poundland has recorded a surge in sales of its what type of kit costing £1 for three? That's pregnancy testing kits. Pound for a pack of three pregnancy kits. There you go. Reliable to a fault, accurate within a mile. Number four, originally set to take place in April and May in Sheffield, what world championship has been rescheduled for the end of July? That's the Snooker World Championship. What else happens in Sheffield? Snooker. Number five, now a common term, name given to temporary leave of employees due to special needs of a company or economic conditions, furlough. Number six, Michael O'Neill has permanently left his role as the manager of Northern Ireland after 8 years in charge. Number seven, the combination of Comet Relief and Children in Need, the BBC's big charity event was the Big Night In. Was that in or in? The Big Night In. Number eight, the annual signing of new talent into American football was NFL, took place last week, albeit by video, and that was the NFL draft or the draft. Not a Wednesday night. The strippers are on a Thursday night straight after the only open mic night, I'm afraid, Eldrick. Number nine, the founder of the first pirate radio station off the UK, Ronan O'Reilly, has died, sadly, aged 79. That was Radio Caroline. And number 10, Captain Tom Moore has joined forces with Michael Ball and the NHS Voices of Care Choir on a cover of You'll Never Walk Alone. Right, after round two, we move on to round three. Round three was your top five. The first one, we went for the new play and we went for these. I gave you five gifts and I wanted you to tell me the films they came from. Number one was Top Gun. Have you seen that one, Ian? Number two, we're going to talk about a little bit of Shake and Bake. That's Talladega Nights. Number three, it's got Russell, it's got Stallone, it's Tango and Cash. Number four, I'm really hesitant about this one because I checked several times. I'm saying Terminator, but I'm persuaded if you want to say Terminator 2, you can have it, just because I'm suspicious that he looks a little bit older than the original Terminator. But I looked at the original Terminator ones and he doesn't look much different. So Terminator or Terminator 2, you can have it. And number 5, your final one, it's my hairstylist. It's There's Something About Mary. Question 2 was the animated TV series. Would you find the following locations? Springfield. That's The Simpsons. Bedrock was the Flintstones. Greendale. That's the lovely village where you'll find Postman Pat. After Greendale, we had Quahog, which is Family Guy. Yeah, they recreate it in the second one as well, Ruth. You might find it at number 24 or something in your top 100 films when you eventually get there. Number 5, I gave you Ponty Pandy. If you don't know Ponty Pandy, you don't know nothing about kids' TV. It's Fireman Sam. Round 4 was your A to Z. Or your Alpha Links. Number 1, which home carbonation system was founded in 1903 and was floated on the Nasdaq in 2010? That's SodaStream. Number 2, what name is given to the Haribo Ranger Super Sour Tangy Gums? That's Tangfastics. Number 3, what name links a mythical creature in Britain's biggest supplier of darts equipment? Karis has decided to post a lovely photo of herself sat with a huge cuddly unicorn on her sofa and a can of Brewdog. I can't work out what beer it is, and she just sent me a video of them playing it with Joe, or with her playing with the unicorn as well. There you go. So it's a unicorn. Number 4, Nicolas Maduro is the current president of which South American country? Venezuela. Number 5, the name of the favourite cheese of animated characters Wallace and Gromit is Wensleydale. Number 6, the name which was shared by two kings of Persia between 486 BC and 424 BC is Xerxes, Xerxes, Xerxes. Number 7, what is shouted in a popular game if all your 5 dice are the same number? That's Yahtzee. Number 8, in which film did Michael Caine play Lieutenant Gonville Bromhead of the 24th Battalion of Foot, later to become one of the Warwickshire regiments, I believe, and misguided in his military tactics by a Royal Engineer captain? That's Zulu. Number 9, what is the alternative name of the ancient device also known as a counting frame? That's an abacus. And number 10, what name is given to the thin pancakes usually served with caviar? That's a blini. A blini. Little tiny pancakes with caviar. Right, round 5, straight after round 4, we go into your connections round. The triple point of what substance is used to define the Celsius temperature scale? That's water. Water. Are you going on about the lyrics to Fireman Sam there, Ruth? Have you had that many drinks tonight? Number 2, which box office hit of 1990 almost starred Paul Hogan until Patrick's race took over the lead after Hogan turned it down. I tell you what, Ghost would have been a totally different film with Paul Hogan wrapping his arms around Demi Moore on the potter's wheel. You call that a pottery? This is a pottery. Number three, Wimbledon is now the only Grand Slam tennis tournament played on what surface? That's grass. By the time it came out in the UK, Joe, it was 1990. Those days, it took a while to get the film strip across the Atlantic. Number four, what mythical creature appears on the flag of Wales? That's a dragon. Hi, Mum. Oh, look. IMDb, Ghost, 1990. If you're going to comment, Joe, make sure you've got the facts. And question five, what links the previous four? So you've got water, ghost, grass, and dragon. They're all varieties of Pokemon. Pokemon. Yes, it's got that bad. That was 1987, Joe. Sorry. Dirty Dancing. It scarred me as a child. There you go. Right, round six. Wipe out. If you get all 10 of these right, you get a bonus of 5 points. If you get anything wrong in this round, you lose all the points for the round. Be honest. If you wrote something down, it's an answer. I think Paul's probably in his garden, James, trying to catch what Pokemon he can. The sweets, now known as Starburst, were originally known as what in Britain between 1959 and 1990? Well, they made your mouth water. It's opal fruits. Swapsy time. There we go. Nearly covered myself up again. Number two, who played the part of Ron Weasley in the Harry Potter films? That's Rupert Grint. Number three, the current major house of fashion who manufactured uniforms for the German SS during the 1930s was Hugo Boss. There isn't a snake type of Pokemon, Rich. It's a poison type of Pokemon. So you're looking for the mythical creature, which is the dragon, as opposed to a snake, unfortunately. I can clearly tell you snakes aren't mythical because there's one across the other side of my office who likes to be handled every now and again. And I fed him the other day. Question four, there are thrift shops in the USA and op shops in Australia. What name are they known in the UK? That's charity shops. We've got a famous one in Bulwell where Sue works. Oh, the bonus of snakes. Yeah, you can, if you've got snakes, I suppose, yeah. Thank you, James, for clearing that up. Snakes also wins as a bonus if you've got snakes down. Water snakes, grass snakes, ghost snakes, and dragon snakes, that's fine. It's like Only Connect. If you can make it work, you can make it work. Thank you, Matthew, and James, and Richard. All right. Number five, which television presenter is nicknamed the Hamster? That's Richard Hammond. I love the fact there's a delay between the comments that are coming in and what I've already said. So I'm seeing the comments coming in about the snakes. Yes, I'll accept that as a connection. That's fine. Number six, the Achilles being an example. What is name given to strong fibrous tissue that attaches a muscle to a bone? Tendon. Number seven, the Bass Strait separates which island from Australia? That's Tasmania. Number eight, who is the lexicographer, adjudicator, and longest serving member of the on-screen team on Countdown? That's the lovely Susie Dent. And number nine, Chris Lowe and Neil Tennant make up the Pet Shop Boys. Number 10, the name of the womanizing barman played by Ted Danson in the TV sitcom Cheers. That's Sam Malone. Sam Malone. Your quiz is out of 60. But don't forget I gave you the tiebreak as well. The tiebreak was, in which year was actress Betty Davis born? That's 1908. 1908. Four was Charity Shop. Yes, Zoe. Right, start firing your scores in. It's out of 60. Fire your scores in, please. So, people are already firing their scores in already. So, we've got the B team plus with a score of 56. Quick Jizz coming in hot for 55. Bugger, 42. We blew it on the last round. We went vintage instead of charity. And I'm next door with 42. Well done, next door. Quite impressed with that. 49, Lord and Lady Glover. 45, just Julian. 58 for the Uber Troopers. 57 for Emma. 54 for Graham. 49 for Jax. Griffles got 56. Mr. Pell got 59. I've been waiting for you to do that to me, James. 59 points. Well done, sir. 36 for Carly. Sherwood Swingers plus 2 scored 48. That is a new record, Lucy and crew. Well done. 55 for Pippa. 48 for Mulligans. Matthew, 59 out of 60. You put Gary Cinnamon instead of Jerry Cinnamon. That's honesty for you, for the girls in it. Getting 59 out of 60 when you could have easily blagged the 60. Well done. I'm impressed that you were honest there. 45 for the Grudgeons. 33 for Simon. 42 for Kai. 46 for Oliver. For Oliver, that's part of the Grudgeons. Or correcting himself. 46 for Brown. Andrew, well done. 55 for Ruth and the crew. Top score for Splinter Team. Thank you, Terry. Cameron got 50. Impressed, Cameron. Well done. Oh my God, Dukes of Hazzard have just got their first full house-ish, having played from the start. 59 points. Breakfast Club with 54. Von Trapp Swingers with 47. Ellen J got 53. I've got a feeling I was a bit too lenient this week. 39 for Lynn. 58 for Grub Group. Girls in it, 59. Yes, Kirsty, what have you been giving that one? There's Quizrables got 47. 56 for Buddy Brilliant. 52 for Lorna. Quizzing My Hair for 46. Transatlantic Quizzes for 37. Uncle Wally, 53. This is the fun bit, trying to get through all these. Ellen and Phil with 36. 61, yeah, that's quite impressive, Christy. It's out of 60, so I know you two are terrible at adding up in the first place, so I'm going to say that's 16, yeah? Is that right? Pete, Mandy and Helena got 39. Come on. Good quiz, like the film round. Thank you, Ben. 44 for the Wardles, 54 for Richard Ghost Ship, 55 Kev Buxton, 38 for Nob. Nob got 38. Not bad for first time, Dorian. Dawn and Nick with 48. What did the other 59ers put for tiebreak? Oh, that's a good point, Matthew. James, what was your tiebreak? Uber Troopers, what was your tiebreak answers? Come on. Yeah, the answers are going up in a second, 2 seconds. I'll stick the answers up now. Oh, come on. Thirty-eight for the Not-So-Smarts, 54 for We Beat Richard Shaw with 58, A Up Bab with 50. Liam got 1904 on the tie break. Come on, what else we got? Monkey's got 59. Elise, what did you go for the tie break though? Come on, what did you go for the tie break? Matthew, I've got your tie break answer. James, what was your tie break? No, I just need the those that were on 59. Nick, what was your main score? Come on. 56, 45. Cheers, Craig. I'm looking forward to having some of that ginger cake. 59 for the Von Trapp family swingers. They've got 1922 on the tiebreak. James got 1906. Who was the other one? Matthew got 1913, so James is 2 years out so far, which is doing well. I only want the tie breaks of those that got 59. I'm thinking James got 59 and 1906. He's the closest so far, unless, yeah, you're 2 years out as well, Lee. So we've got two teams that were on 59 points and 2 years out on the tie break. It's all for fun, so we'll leave it at a tie between Monkeys and Mr. Pell. Thank you, Dawn. Good night. God bless. Safe travels home, all. Does that work? I don't know. Does it work? So, good night. See you next week. One, two, three.